People call them builders of nations, but I choose to call them nation builders. Some say they are stingy, but I say they are very, very intelligent. They are a guide to the society. Some people say they are stern and strict, and some say they are fond of counting stuffs in the kitchen, especially meat in the pot. Some people say they are poor, average, and very calculating. Most at times, they prefer quantity over quality. I guess you know who I'm talking about. It's a teacher. Today in this video, we are going to x-ray the financial life of a teacher through the eyes of Robert T. Kiyosaki. And for those who don't know Robert T. Kiyosaki, he is a multi-millionaire based in America. He has written this famous book called Rich Dad, Poor Dad, and other books like The Cash Flow Quadrant. He's written over 19 books, and his recent book is titled Fake Teachers, Fake Money, Fake Asset. But in this video, we are interested in seeing the financial life of a teacher. This question has always been bugging me over the years, that why are teachers so wretched? Why are some poor? So I decided to look for a solution to this question by doing a retrospective study. In this study, we decided to look at teachers who taught subjects like economics, commerce, accounting, and financial math. Subjects that had to deal with money, and to see if these teachers understood what they were teaching and were able to apply this to better their financial lives. We left out other subject areas like history, philosophy, law, and science of education, because those teachers, from the beginning, it's not like mathematics, so their own financial situation is well known. After doing this study for a while, we discovered that these teachers fall into these various categories. Some were poor, some were average, others look rich, but they were highly indebted. As we're analyzing the data we had collected, these words keep coming up. They were the bank, loans, interest rate. The bank, loans, and interest rate. So I decided to dig deeper. I started with the banks to look at the bank system in Cameroon, and I discovered that the big and very rich banks had 2/3 of their customers made of teachers. Why teachers? Why only these banks that contain teachers are so rich than the others, are outperforming the other banks? Next, I wanted to know what kind of loans these teachers take from the banks. And what I discovered was that all the loans they took had 3 things in common. First, these loans did not require any collateral, and you could borrow up to 8 million. Secondly, these loans had a fixed payment period of 60 months. And third, fixed interest rate of 11.5%. What actually attracted them to take such loans with very high interest rate and a fixed time period? The next on the list was interest rate. So I decided to go to one of these banks, as if I was a member of the bank, in order to understand how they gave out their loans. But fortunately for me, when I got to the bank, I met a friend who was having a bitter conversation with one of the loan managers about the loan he took. When I confronted him and asked what was going on, he said that a few months back he was desperately in need of money, so he came here and took a loan. While taking the loan manager did not tell him everything about the loan, what was involved in it. So they told him that he was going to take the $600,000, pay it over 60 months at an interest rate of 11.5, and they agreed to a monthly payment of $15,000. What happened that he, being a mathematics teacher, could go in for such a loan? Obviously, teachers are always desperate, so that is no news. Here was a point where I understood that despite these teachers knowing about financial dealings, they know about the simple interest and loans that they teach, especially for the commerce teachers, economics, accounting, and even financial. What actually did the loan manager tell him before he went for this loan? Could it be that they used the non-collateral? Maybe because he was going to pay $15,000 per month over 60 months, he did not feel the accumulative effect that that money was going to have on him in the long run. I decided, let me do some mathematics from what he told me. Get your jotter and get your pen and let's do mathematics. Mind you that all these things I'm doing today, I am looking at this financial situation through the eyes of Robert T. Kiyosaki. He went in for a loan saying that he was going to take 600,000 francs. And pay it for 60 months, paying 15,000 monthly. So if you take 15,000 times 60 months, it's going to give you 900,000. Therefore, taking 900,000 minus 600,000 is 300,000. So what the loan officer told him was that he was going to pay just 15,000 for a month. But he forgot to understand that he was taking this money at an interest rate of 11.5%. So at this moment, he was to pay an additional $300,000 without interest. If you want to calculate the simple interest, our formula for simple interest is, simple interest is equal to amount times time times rate divided by, because our time is in months, we're going to divide it by 1,200. So if we do the mathematics, so we'll have 600,000, I hope you're writing, times 60 months, times 11.5%, divided by 1,200. It's going to give you 345,000. Now this is 345,000 he is going to pay for a period of 60 months. To know the amount of interest he was to pay in a month, let's take the total amount of interest divided by the number of months, which is 345,000 francs divided by 60. If you do that, it's going to give you 5,750 francs. So when you take these 5,750 francs as interest on the 15,000 for 1 month, he was supposed to pay 15,000 plus 5,750, which is 20,750. This was what got him very annoyed. When he went back to the loan manager, he saw that instead of 15,000 francs to be deducted from his monthly salary, 20,700 francs was instead deducted. That's where the conflict was coming from. So meaning that he took 600,000, he paid 300,000 because of the time frame of the loan, and he paid 345,000 as interest. Altogether, he was to pay back 1,245,000, which means that this bank made a 100% gain from this teacher. Tell me, how will teachers in Cameroon be rich? If he had done his mathematics earlier, before even going to the bank to ask for that amount of money, he would have paid a much more lesser money. Look at what would have happened. The simple interest that I've calculated on the 600,000 is 345,000. Take now this 345,000 and add to the 600,000, it will give you 945,000. This was the amount of money he was supposed to pay in 60 months. Take the 945,000 divided by 60 months, it means per month he was supposed to pay 15,750. That was the amount he was supposed to pay. But since he was played on, each month he was given an additional 5,000 francs to the bank. This is the power of simple interest. They teach it, but they don't understand the practicality of it. If a mathematics teacher can make this kind of mistake, financial mistake, which is life costing, what more of history teacher? What more of those that go to study science of education? By reading Rich Dad Poor Dad, I was able to understand the mechanics of money. I am simply sharing this book because after I read it, my understanding of finance management actually changed. Looking at the financial situations of the teacher that we have just studied in this video, I did it based on the knowledge I gained from reading his book. If you like it, please check it out. Now, if this video is interesting to you, please send it to a teacher who is about to go and take one of those tricky loans called the school fees loan to stop or go in there for knowing what he is up against. Please share this video and help teachers. Let's try to alleviate the situation of teachers. Comment and like. If you're new to this channel, please subscribe. We make new videos every week, and we make videos on topics like entrepreneur, success, lifestyle, and healthy living. Thanks for subscribing. Salam.